General Washington here with a playthrough of the new content that was added. That said, I have not played any of it yet, so I may struggle in parts of the episode.
Cordial greetings. I request your presence at a gathering on Station Deep Space Nine. We shall discuss the Borg Kingdom problem and potential solutions. We live at a perilous time, friend, but recall our axiom. Through harmony, we are secure. Through unity, we are strong. Together we will strive to defeat our mutual enemy and establish peace for one and all. We shall discuss the Borg Kingdom problem and potential solutions. We live at a perilous time, friend, but recall our axiom. Through harmony, we are secure. Through unity, we are strong. Together we will strive to defeat our mutual enemy and establish peace for one and all.
Welcome to Deep Space Nine. Tossin Fey, the leader of the Aetherian starship Harmony, will be making a presentation soon, alongside one of our finest captains. While you're waiting, I encourage you to meet with the specialists here to get their insights on the upcoming operation.
Tholians are often slow to place trust in outsiders. While the Aetherians did provide timely aid against the Borg Kingdom, their extra-dimensional origins raised a number of questions within our leadership ranks. We know very little about them. While others may place their trust in them, it will not be easily won with my people.
We've held off the Borg Kingdom before, and we're ready to do it again. Our new allies were eager to join the fight, and I certainly can't argue with the results. The Aetherians have been in non-stop talks with the Alliance Command Staff since they arrived here. I have a feeling that whatever they've cooked up is going to be big. Maybe on a scale we haven't seen since the Iconian War.
Good to see you, my friend. It seems we're about to set off on another bold undertaking soon. The arrival of the Aetherians was rather fortunate for those in the Alliance. Adding a new ally against the Borg Kingdom may well tip the odds into our favor. I suppose we'll learn of the action plan soon enough. I do hope it's a good one.
Just heard from Ops. The briefing is about to start.
Thank you all for coming. The attacks from the Borg Kingdom are a threat to us all. We've been working on a strategy with the Aetherians. Several tactical initiatives are underway as we speak, but there is a new, critical issue to deal with.
A reality vortex has appeared in what you call fluidic space. That region has a unique, extra-dimensional nature. It connects to every point in the multiverse. If our enemy controls that vortex, they will be able to attack anywhere, at any time. Unfortunately, fluidic space disrupts Aetherian neural processes.
So, the task of closing that vortex falls to us. I'll be leading a strike force to fluidic space to get the job done. Hopefully, we'll achieve our objectives before hostile forces arrive. We will do what we must to succeed. Thank you for your time.
May I speak with you for a moment? Sincere greetings. It is an honor to be working with an officer of such high caliber. We are grateful indeed. We have learned much throughout our conflict with the Borg Kingdom. We were happy to share our knowledge, and we have provided technology that will improve your effectiveness against them in battle. Quite so. I believe you will find them most effective against our common foe. I believe Captain Dax wanted to speak with you before you depart. Are there any questions I can answer for you at this time? Most of our universe has known peace for many a galactic cycle. Our Concordium has been an integral reason for that. Occasional conflicts would occur from time to time, but most were resolved peacefully, until the arrival of the Borg Kingdom. We have known of them, and the nature of their universe, for many cycles. We did not establish conflict due to their hateful, violent tendencies. Unfortunately, they discovered our universe. Despite our efforts to prevent conflict, they followed their nature and launched a brutal invasion into our space. For the first time in countless cycles, war came to the Aetherian Concordium. After many cycles of relentless conflict, we have managed to drive them back to their own universe. The cost has been terrible. Entire civilizations lost to warfare, to assimilation, and now they are here, in your universe, seeking once again to subjugate untold trillions. We will not let them succeed. What happened in our universe must not happen here. We have known of them and the nature of their universe for many cycles. We did not establish conflict due to their hateful, violent tendencies. Unfortunately, they discovered our universe. Despite our efforts to prevent conflict, they followed their nature and launched a brutal invasion into our space. For the first time in countless cycles, war came to the Aetherian Concordium. Do you have any more questions for me? If not, Captain Dax would like to speak to you next.
Hello there. Nice to finally meet you. You've got quite the reputation. I'm glad you and your crew are joining us on the mission. We need the best and brightest against the Borg Kingdom. Glad to hear it. Fluidic space can be challenging, and that's before you add the Undine to the equation. They're not terribly fond of anything from our part of space-time. We're hoping to avoid any sort of incident with them, but shutting down that vortex is our top priority. The defense upgrades we received from the Aetherians are impressive. The enhancements to targeting, weapon modulation, and power systems will really make a big difference. They've also provided extensive tactical data on Borg Kingdom vessels and defense systems. We'll be ready for action should we run into them on the mission. Once we're back on our ships, my crew will use tech on the Aventine to open a quantum singularity. We'll use that to travel to fluidic space. Are you ready to go?
Task force has assembled. Head to the following coordinates, and the Aventine will create the quantum singularity.
Task force, this is docking control. Confirm your boards are green for departure.
Aventine to docking control. Boards are green.
Inoue reporting. Everything is green on our end.
Docking control, Riscava reports green for departure.
Acknowledged, task force. You are cleared for departure.
I
hope you don't learn about its dangers, like the Undine.
Thank you.
All ships, make way to the designated coordinates. We're all set over here. Ready to take a trip to fluidic space? Transit complete. All stations report they're ready for action. Hope your helm's up to the task of piloting in fluidic space. The local currents can get a bit unruly.
Unfortunately, local conditions are generating an unusual amount of sensor interference. We're not exactly flying blind, but our scanning quality is quite limited.
Neither do I. If the Undine find us, we might not know they're coming until it's too late. And trust me, you do not want to be on the wrong end of an Undine ambush. Let's start with a coordinated long-range scan. See if we can gather more information working together. If that doesn't work, we can use deep space probes. By linking probes as we travel, we can create a sensor network. That should extend our scanning range considerably.
Let's meet at the designated location ahead. Long-range scan complete. We're not detecting any sign of the vortex. I think it's time we try Plan B. Let's send out a deep space probe.
Monitor the probe trajectories. No telling how local currents will affect them.
Good idea. A shift in current could divert them into an obstacle.
We should head to the designated location.
Fascinating. I do hope to return one day to conduct research.
Good luck with that. The Undine might have other ideas.
Look for any EM field spikes or drops. Could be caused by the vortex. Long-range scan complete. Even with the probes, we're not finding anything.
Probes on standby. Try these coordinates. We picked up something faint over there for a moment. Might be a sensor glitch, or it might be what we're looking for. Let's head to the next coordinates.
I wonder if fluidic space affects Undine's sensors as much as ours.
Assume they'll see us before we see them.
I know those biosigns. It's a pod of Gekli.
I think we've got something. Attention, all hands. We're detecting weapon fire ahead.
Yes, and that's not all. We're also reading Borg Kingdom weapon signatures. Looks like they picked a fight with the Undine. Are you sure that's wise? We might wind up fighting both the Undine and the Borg.
Then again, the Undine may think twice about firing on us if we help them with the Borg. I think it's worth the risk.
So much for the peaceful journey through fluidic space.
I'm surprised it took this long to run into the Undine.
Target Borg vessels only.
Anomaly. It is in a nearby sector, occupied by a Borg unit complex. A fleet of their warships defends it. It seems we have a common problem, and a common enemy. I propose a tactical alliance between us. We will remove Borg occupation forces from fluidic space, and eliminate the disruptive anomaly together. Unexpected, yes. Incomprehensible. Your alliance is in fact composed of a number of former enemies. Surely a temporary expansion of said alliance is feasible. Very well. We will travel to the provided coordinates when you are ready. A warning. Combat will be imminent upon our arrival. They are. You are as Undine in their minds until further notice. Now, make ready for battle. Our enemy awaits.
Watch out for the spheres. They may try to ram your ship and self-destruct.
The Undine weapons are fascinating.
Target shield.
Aliens are at hand. We need to destroy the Borg unit complex, but our weapons are having little to no effect against its shields.
I believe I have a solution, but it's a risky one. The Aventine was designed to fight Borg. There are a number of anti-Borg systems on board, including a quantum field focus phaser. Properly recalibrated, we could use it to create a brief transporter window through their shields. Once we've opened the window, we'll beam away teams over to the Unicomplex. They'll find and disable the shielding around the Unicomplex, leaving it vulnerable to attack.
A warning. The Unicomplex has considerable defense systems and a fleet protecting it. We will need to eliminate all defenses and enemy vessels before you can safely lower your shields and use transporters.
Right. Moving into range now. Clear the local defense nodes and watch out for reinforcements.
We're on it. Work fast, Captain.
Moving to defend the Aventine. Good luck, Ezri.
Hard to believe the Undine can't put a dent in the Unicomplex.
If there's one thing the Borg excel at, it's adaptation.
Even to a weapon.
We made it. Now the real work begins. Two hazard teams, designations Alpha and Beta. Alpha's job is to take down the Unicomplex shield systems, while Beta will shut down the weapons and tactical arrays. If we're lucky, we'll be able to get the job done without firing a shot. I'll provide each team with some Starfleet gear designed to mask our life signs. None of us will show up on Borg sensors. We should be able to reach our destinations before they can detect us and scramble security teams. Once we've finished, we'll evac to our respective ships and regroup with the Undine forces.
You know, This could be a golden opportunity to collect intel on these guys.
Keep it to surface level intrusion. Too much digging around could draw unwanted attention.
Initial battle with ISS Voyager was inconclusive. Borg casualties, 100%. Terran vessel eluded capture. Priority alert issued. Initiate sector-wide hunt for ISS Voyager.
So the Borg Kingdom ran into the mirror version of Voyager. Sounds like their Captain Janeway made them regret that. Can't say I feel sorry about it.
Ezri, are you certain we'll remain undetected?
The gear worked well in simulations.
Wait, this is experimental tech?
Ah, let's hope this plan survives contact with the enemy then.
So far, so good. The drones can't detect us. Dax to Beta Team. Report.
We're almost to weapon control, Captain.
Good work, Commander. Proceed. Update me if anything changes. Dax out.
Efforts to track and capture ISS Voyager. Successful. Borg casualties, 23%. 98% of Terran crew assimilated during combat. Directive. Conduct detailed evaluation of Captain Catherine Janeway. Objective. Determine tactics and command ability necessary to defeat and evade Borg forces. Assimilation is not approved.
My God. Things were a lot worse for the Mirror Voyager and her crew. 98% assimilation. Studying their Janeway like a lab rat to learn how to think and fight like her. Strange they didn't do that by assimilating her, though. I suppose they wanted the pure, authentic data, unfiltered by algorithms and cybernetic interfaces.
I don't believe those drones are passive!
Beta team to Dax! We're under attack! The Borg found us!
So much for experimenting.
Defend yourself, and be prepared to remodulate weapons.
Understood, Captain. Beta team, out.
Hang in there, Commander. We'll rescue him if we can. Fortify your position if possible. Weld the doors shut if you have to. Alpha will reinforce you once we've taken out the shields.
Copy that, Captain. Beta team, out.
That's the energy beam the Borg are firing into the vortex. Our initial scans of it weren't conclusive. It appears to be causing a tremendous level of fluctuation within the vortex core. Good question. I'm willing to bet it's nothing good. Right. There should be a control console somewhere in the chamber ahead. If we can find it, we might be able to learn more about the beam and its purpose. Maybe even shut it down. That console might have data on that beam. Let's check it out. What were you able to find? I was afraid of something like this. It looks like the Borg are trying to modulate the vortex, control it. From what I can tell, they're trying to expand it in size, considerably. It gets worse. From what I know about Undine technology, if they fire one of those planet killer beams at the Unicomplex while this beam is active, it could cause an explosion that makes a matter-antimatter reaction look tame. We need to shut this thing down before the Undine get trigger happy, or they could destroy most of fluidic space, and us with it. No, unfortunately. I think I've located the console that will shut it down nearby, though.
door to shield control is just ahead.
They're probably on lockdown by now.
Not wrong. Haven't I? I'll override the control.
That didn't take long. Multiple drones are closing in.
Well, at least they're consistent.
Enemy target.
Doors open. You're in business.
Flanking damage detected.
Thank you.
enemy targets on sensors.
Take out that drone, the dendritic one.
Thank you.
We made it. Now the real work begins.
You know, this could be a golden opportunity to collect intel on these guys.
Keep it to surface level intrusion. Too much digging around could draw unwanted attention.
Ezri, are you certain we'll remain undetected?
The gear worked well in simulations.
Wait, this is experimental tech?
Ah, let's hope this plan survives contact with the enemy then.
So far, so good. The drones can't detect us. Dax to Beta Team, report.
We're almost to weapon control, Captain.
Good work, Commander. Proceed. Update me if anything changes. Dax out.
I don't believe those drones are passive.
Beta team to Dax. We're under attack. The Borg found us.
So much for experimenting.
Defend yourself. And be prepared to remodulate weapons.
Understood, Dax. Beta team out.
Fortify your position if possible. Weld the doors shut if you have to. Alpha will reinforce you once we've taken out the shields.
Copy that, Captain. Beta team, out.
That's the energy beam the Borg are firing into the vortex. Our initial scans of it weren't conclusive. It appears to be causing a tremendous level of fluctuation within the vortex core. Good.
The console might have data on that beam. Let's check it out.
We'll have to deal with those drones first.
What were you able to find? It looks like it gets worse. No, unfortunately.
believe the door to shield control is just ahead.
They're probably on lockdown by now.
You're not wrong. Cover me. I'll override the controls.
That didn't take long. Multiple drones are closing in.
Well, at least they're consistent. Take out that drone, the dendritic one. Well done, Commander. Proceed with your mission. Shields will be down shortly. Back then.
State your designation. Resistance will be terminated. State your designation.
Interface with console to complete interrupted subtask.
Acknowledged. Assimilation complete. Stand by for instructions. Update. Drone 1 of 5. Initiate function at designated alcove. Retrieve drone data from regeneration alcove.
Drone 1 of 5. Provide task status. Interface with Mackle monitor. Drone 1 of 5. Assist with drone assimilation at designated console. Complete assimilation of drone. Drone 1 of 5. Provide task status. Interlink with drone. Update. Drone 1 of 5. Escort damaged drone to alcove for regeneration. Escort drone to regeneration alcove for integration. Transfer drone data to regeneration alcove. Drone 1 of 5. Provide task status. Update. Drone 1 of 5. Repel borders in weapon control.
Okay, that should do it. Try it now.
Stop them immediately.
Wait, did you hear something?
We've got company.
Fall back to our position. Reinforcements are on their way.
Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation. Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation. Drone 1 of 5. Provide task status. Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation. objective update. Recover critical components from neutralized Borg drone. Drone 1 of 5. Provide task status. Update. Drone 1 of 5. Neutralize remaining intruders and restore full weapon control. Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation.
Beta team to death. We're being overrun.
Shields are still up. We can't see you out.
Oh no. That's the rest of Alpha team. They've been assimilated.
Get out of there. Run. Run!
Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation. Target threat nullified. Begin assimilation. Complete restoration of weapon control. Interface with designated console. One of five. Provide task status. Update. Drone one of five. Transport to shield control and neutralize all intruders.
Dax to beta team. Come in. There's no answer.
Remember the mission. We need to take those shields out. We can help Beta Team once we're done.
Let's make haste, then.
Right. Let's get it done.
Look out! Captain Dax, are you okay? Kamarke, look out!
Stop! You know me! We're allies! Help! Someone help me!
One of five. Status report. Drone.
Can you hear me? Are you okay? Are you with us? Glad to hear it. Welcome back. Are you ready to go? Now the real work begins. Are you able to proceed with the mission? There's no shame in saying no. If you need to recuperate, I understand. I injected you with nanotech designed to sever the link between your drone and the rest of the board. It's key to your individual biosignature, and only works for a short time after assimilation. Thankfully, we got to you in your time and time. Okay, there's still time to rescue Beta Team, but right now, we need to complete our primary mission here. We're locked out of the shield controls now. Do you have any insight from your experience with the board that could help us crack the code? Judging by the look on your face, I'm guessing you weren't successful. And that's good. Once we rescue Beta Team, we'll send them back here to await transmission of the control code. That should let us take the shields down before the board block access again.
Ready weapons! Here they come!
The Vinculum is a priority target.
Are we in time? Have they been assimilated?
They're inactive. We can help them.
Praise Luca.
We need to hurry before more Borg arrive.
Beta Team is a little rattled, but they're ready to proceed with the mission. They're ready to transport back to shield control. They'll hold the position and wait for us to provide the access codes. Are you ready to proceed? Check the ceilings for Vincula.
And watch out for bomber drones!
I have a very bad feeling about this.
The This looks like a command center. Okay, let's see if we can take their shields down here.
You won't be shutting anything down, Captain. This is where your resistance will be annihilated. No, it can't be. Not always pleasant to look in the mirror, is it, Harry? Now, the smart move here would be to surrender for assimilation. But I know you, Harry, better than anyone. You're going to play the hero for the last time.
Vincula, take them out first.
You're strong. Stronger than most, to be sure. But as the board where you come from say, resistance is futile. You're going to shoot at the king. Don't miss.
Looks like the magic
is
going
to be on the right. The king has a nanite shield. It'll reflect our fire.
Watch out for the nanite swarms. They look dangerous.
His nanite shield is back. Check your fire. The pipes are moving again. Be ready for more Vincula.
To make new drones when we're done here.
No, I will die before it.
found some powerful friends, Harry. Word to the wise. Watch your allies closely. Their smile might be hiding a knife.
Assimilated. I will not allow it.
It's going to be all right. You're safe with us. Harry.
Captain Kim.
We need to return to our ships, Captain. This is far from over.
I've heard encounters with your mirror self can be rough, but I not only met him, I fought him. And saw him die. Yeah, I'll be fine. I am a little worried about Kamarte, though. I know she's been through a lot, but kill someone in cold blood, even a Borg. Right. We still have a job to do, no matter what.
Please tell me you have the command. Data team reports the codes were effective. The Unicomplex shields are down.
Shut down the central beam they were firing into the vortex while you were captured, but now they're firing three beams at it. It looks like they're trying to escalate whatever it was they were doing to the vortex when we arrived. Easier said than done. While most of the Unicomplex is unshielded, the Borg have large capital ships shielding the emitters. We'll have to deal with those ships before we can take out the emitters. The Undine Planet Killer is en route to this location, but it won't be able to fire until the emitters are out of commission. We need to take them down as soon as possible.
The Undine are still with us, moving into formation.
They're doing their part, Captain. Time to do ours. If we don't take these emitters out, we all lose.
Picking up the look of life,
nice work. Beta emitter is vulnerable. Take it out.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Emitter Beta is down. Next stop, Point Gamma. Ethereum upgrades keep us in the fight.
I'm reading a considerable increase in Borg defenses there. Helm, best speed to Point Gamma. Engage.
That octahedron won't go down without a fight.
It's in our way.
Emitter Gamma's defense field is down. You know what to do.
Ship is under attack.
I'm picking up a huge energy source at Point Delta. We need to get over there, fast. Reading the planet killer on long-range sensors. It'll be here soon.
Right. No pressure.
Alliance vessels, the situation grows severe. Destroy the final emitter. We will do the rest.
Understood. We're on it.
Help. Best speed to Point Delta. No time to lose.
Thank you. There goes its defense field. Take it out.
The Alliance and Undine vessel, I offer sincere greetings. You have succeeded against staggering odds. Correct. However, the Harmony is safely within the spatial anomaly once occupied by the Unicomplex. There is no fluidic material of any kind in here. It is, as you might say, a pocket of normal space. A valid question. We are here to prevent another incursion by the Borg Kingdom. They do not give up easily. We believe that unchecked, the odds of them attempting to recreate a vortex are high. Simply put, we must be vigilant. I can't say I'm surprised they turned down your offer. Still, what happened here today may very well be the first step toward better relations with the Undine in the future. I think it's time for us to go home. Wouldn't want to wear out our welcome after all. Are you ready to depart? Made it. I expect there are plenty of people eagerly awaiting our report on DS9. Then let's not keep them waiting. See you there. Before we turn in our reports, let's stop by medical and have those Borg implants removed. I happen to know one of the doctors there very well. He'll take good care of you. I'll let them know you're coming. Are you ready to go?
There you are. Welcome back. The procedure was a complete success. No more Borg implants for you. Is the patient cleared for duty, Doctor?
Yes, of course.
Then if you're up for it, the command staff wants to debrief us.
Be safe out there. Doctor's orders.
I have to say, Borg modifications weren't a good look for you. Thankfully, my chief medical officer was available to remove those. Besides being my husband, Julian's one of Starfleet Medical's best. Don't mention it. Between you and me, I'm concerned about Kamarke. I was a counselor on DS9 during the Dominion War. I know post-traumatic stress when I see it. She's a fine officer. We'll need people like her out there if the Borg Kingdom comes back for a rematch. That's a worry for another day, though. For now, their invasion is over. Thanks for all you and your crew did to make that happen.
I don't know about you, but it's good to be back. I don't plan on visiting fluidic space again anytime soon. I'm still processing the fact that we fought alongside the Undine. They aren't exactly known for being team players, at least as far as the Alliance is concerned. Anything's possible, but I wouldn't expect an invitation to any holiday parties from them anytime soon. For now, it's like a wise man once said, it's in the purview of the diplomat.
Your report on the events in fluidic space was quite thorough. The temporary alliance with the Undine was unexpected, as was the arrival of the Aetherians. I will update the leaders of the Assembly. I suspect they will want to monitor the situation in fluidic space quite closely. Should another incursion occur, they will want to take action.
I reviewed your after-action report. Well done. Losing fluidic space to the Borg Kingdom would have been disastrous. Agreed. This could be a turning point for our relations with the Undine. More than a few members of the Diplomatic Corps are enthused about the possibilities.
Joyous greetings, friend. Your mission was truly a successful venture. Along with the Undine, you have repelled the forces of the Borg Kingdom and disrupted their command structure. With luck, many cycles will pass before they will be able to pose a threat to us again. For that, the Aetherian Concordium owes you our sincere pledge of gratitude. Your efforts prove, once again, that through harmony, we are secure. Through unity, we are strong. May our friendship continue to grow deeper in the cycles to come.
Attention all hands. This is Admiral Hansen. The Borg are en route to the Sol system. Starfleet forces will make our stand here, at Wolf 359. We'll do all we can to stop the Borg. More importantly, we'll mitigate our losses as best we can. Protect Starfleet vessels and personnel whenever possible. The Borg cube is powerful. Destroy as many of its weapons as possible to reduce its power in combat. Be advised, the Borg can regenerate lost weapons over time. Be mindful of this out there. We've received reports that the Borg try to capture ships and their crews. They call this process assimilation. You must be prepared to defend against it. Should any Starfleet vessel fall to assimilation, it will need to be destroyed. Protect ejected life pods from the Borg as well.
You will disarm your
weapons. We can't allow our forces to be added to that of the enemy.
001. If you attempt
this
to intervene,
will not
we will destroy you.
We've never faced an enemy
Gamma
like the Borg.
Engage the Borg.
The line
Bruce
is drawn
Gamma
here.
Hold for now.
We will stop them by any means necessary. We must
Melbourne
protect
here.
Earth.
We're moving
and
in.
The Federation.
Move
that
us to
all.
Position Alpha.
This is Admiral Hansen. Focus on destroying the cube's weapons.
Melbourne to fleet. We've lost them.
They've locked on.
The Yamaguchi is moving in to assist. Protect the life pods. Some of them are carrying civilians.
Engaging the Borg.
Shields have failed. Warning, ship is under attack. failing. Health integrity below 75%. Less shields failing. Your shield's failing.
Thank you.
actual damage.
Remember, if you enjoy the content, please subscribe, hit the bell, like and share. Thank you for playing and watching. Until next time, stay safe.